about that breaking cycle of life. It's Sunday, and you know that it's Sunday Song Spotlight, and I have a great song for you. And I brought you guys inside today because it's snowing outside. I'll see if I can go get some pics for you and post it after this, and then you'll see how beautiful outside is. It's actually not snowing that much, actually. It's really not, it's not that heavy as snow, but it's still pretty. Okay, so today our song for this week is Never Lost a Battle by Elevation Worship, and I really like the Torrin Wells version. The Israel Houghton version is really nice as well, but I kind of like the message at the end of Torrin Wells' version, so I think that's why I prefer it. And if you know this song, you probably agree with me, because that message really, really touched me. But let's get into the song, and then I'll speak about the message of the song after. So it's Never Lost a Battle by Elevation Worship, and it says, first verse, it says, miracles when you move, such an easy thing for you to do. Your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. Your voice is calling me out. Honestly, in this society right now, these days, we don't often see miracles, but trust me, we were in Sabbath school yesterday, and I was, the question that was posed was, because we were speaking about Deuteronomy 28 and the blessings that God has for his people if they obey, right? And I thought to myself, I'm like, you know, if we as Christians, we really just persist in obedience with God, we will definitely see the miracles that he has in store for us. Because not because we don't often see it, it's not that prevalent as it was before. I'm not saying it doesn't happen, because I hear stories. If we but just have that much faith and that level of obedience to be consistent with God, we will see the miracles that God has in store for us. And if we just have that mustard seed faith, I think I mentioned the miracle with Cici Winans and her brother when I was speaking about I Believe. Believe for It by Cici Winans. And it's those miracles that are still happening in this present day that we are reminded with this song that miracles isn't a very easy thing for God to do. It's not that he's up there and not paying attention to us and not wanting to do miracles, but it's the patience that we need to exercise. It's the faith that we need to exercise that will make us see God work the miracle in us, because it's faith that causes his hand to move. Because I was even watching Chosen, it's the perfect fit. I was even watching Chosen yesterday, and it was the recent one that just came out for this week with the woman that touched the hem of his garment, and it made me cry. Even watching it two times, the second time around, I still cried, because she had that much faith just to touch the hem of his garment, and that was the miracle that she needed. So are you exercising the faith? Because really, it's really something that, just as the song says, it's really such an easy thing for him to do, miracles. And if we just have faith and we are just patient, we will see that, yes, with everything that's happening around us, his hand is still moving and he's still showing up, and he's at the tomb of every Lazarus. And I like the fact that they used Lazarus in the song, because he was 4 days late, 4 days late for Lazarus's resurrection, but he was still on time. And we need to be persistent in having faith and being obedient with God to see the miracles that he has in store for us, right? And the pre-chorus says, right now I know you're able. And this song, just like an interlude, this song is like my boosting song for God, one of my boosting songs for God, and a reminder to me to know that, you know, Shanique, even though it looks like the enemy is winning, Jesus never, God never loses a battle. And it's like a pump for him, like, you know, I know you'll win, right? You will never lose a battle. So why should I worry? Because look at you. You are the King of all kings, Lord of all lords, and the commander of my life. And if you are captain, you are commander, you are king, you are lord, then definitely you will never lose a battle. So it's like when I'm like playing this song, it's like a pump for him and then a reminder for me, right? So going on to the pre-chorus, it says, right now I know you're able, and my God, come through again. And the chorus says, you can do all things. You can do all things but fail. Like, he is capable of doing everything except failing, because he never loses a battle. And it goes on to say, because you've never lost a battle. No, you've never lost a battle. And I know you never will. And I want us, when we're listening to this song this week, to really ponder the words of this, that it may look like, guys, I think I need to do a movie of my life, right? Because honestly, when I share my story with others, like me being in the process of my story right now, they're like, you know, if I was in your place, I would give up already. And I'm like, no, that's not going to bring the miracle that I want to see from God, right? And that is what I want us to exercise, especially for 2023, the year of consistency in God. Be consistent with God. Don't let go. Don't give up. Don't just throw in the towel whenever you see a trial come. Go through the trial with God, and you will see that he will definitely be the victor in the end. It doesn't matter how it looks dreary, how it looks dim, how it just looks like definitely we lost the God. Like, literally, we lost. No, he never loses a battle. Be reminded that he never loses a battle, and he never will. And verse 2, it says, everything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost. A new wind is blowing right now, breaking my heart of stone, taking over like it's Jericho. Again, consistency, faith, obedience in God. The story of Jericho. And my walls are all crashing down. It's the persistence. It's the consistency. It's the obedience that will cause the miracles to happen. Even when it seems like everything is done for, like at the very end, remember Lazarus and 7 days. 7 days around the walls of Jericho, and 7 times on the 7th day. They were like, why are we even doing this? But still, it's just the obedience that was necessary. And God blessed the obedience. And that's exactly what he promised in Deuteronomy 28. He's like, if you just obey and follow my will for your life, you will see the blessings that I have in store for you. You will lend to many nations, and you will not borrow, right? If we just keep being obedient to God, being consistent in God, praising him in the rough times, in the hard times, in the happy times and the bad times, guys, we will see God work for us. And then you'll sit back and look like, whoa, I did not see that coming. And I can say I have said that before when it came to God, right? And it's still happening right now. Okay? So I want us to really ponder the words of this song whenever we're singing it. And then it goes into the pre-chorus and the chorus once again. And then the bridge is just repetition of, you never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. You never will. And after the bridge, we have the chorus again, and the song really ends there. But then, when you listen to the Torin Wells version, he goes off into a message, zine. And the message that he has for us in this song, Tarin Wells. He's like, listen, God, he spoke about the second part, the second verse, which is the walls of Jericho. He's like, don't you worry about God ever losing a battle. Basical lessons, I don't remember it like fully, but I know what he's trying to say, right? So I can't quote word for word, but this is basically what he's trying to get across to us. He's like, don't worry about how God is going to win the battle, because look, the enemy is going to come against you, but don't worry, God will even use that same enemy, that same thing that's blocking you from your blessing. The very same thing that is blocking you from your blessing is the very same thing that's going to help you get into your blessings, right? And I'm getting chills just speaking about that part, honestly, because he spoke, he aligned it to, he paralleled it to the walls of Jericho, that it was the very same crumbled walls that were, that was blocking him, blocking the Israelites. It's the very same method that God used. Like, he crumbled the walls and it was the walls that helped them to get in. Like, guys, God is not done with us, like, literally. God will use the very same thing that was designed to keep us out of the blessing, out of the miracles, to bring us into the miracle. And when he said that, when I first heard that, I got chills. And trust me, even up to this point, just speaking about it, I still get chills. And I still get chills when I hear it. And that is a powerful message, to know that if you just hold on, if you just keep still, if you just keep being obedient to God, if you're just persistent, just trusting God, you will see that God never loses a battle. He never loses a battle. And we can rest in the fact that he can do all things but fail. Like, he will never fail because he never lost a battle. So that's really the song for this week. I really love this song. One of my favorites. I pump up God when I'm singing it. I'm like, yeah, you. Don't listen. I'm like, yeah, God, like, come on, like, really, you can do all things, like, you know, a pump for him. And a reminder to me that, why am I even worried about what's really happening around me? Regardless of the darkness, the lightning, the thunder, the everything that could have possibly gone wrong, regardless of it, God will win, and he is by my side through it all. Even when he's silent, he has not forsaken me. Even when it feels like he forsook me, he didn't. And I'm grateful that he's my best friend. And I want him to be your best friend too. That we all can get to the point where we trust and believe in this song and the words of the Bible. That God can do all things. Right? God can do all things but fail. And we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Okay, guys, so that is our song for this week and our devotional for this week. I'll see you on Thursday for Bible study. Bye-bye. Have a great day. Hey, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed today's encouragement, and I hope you guys are ready for the day ahead. Now, do me a favor and press that like button and subscribe button if you are new, so that we can get more of this positive Christian content out into the world, okay? And I'll link my daily devotional playlist right here and my Let's Talk playlist if you want to tackle some social issues, okay? So have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.